Hi, my name is Hannah. I'm a senior BSPS student here at URI, and today I'm talking to Dr. King about undergraduate research experiences and opportunities. So what would you say to students who are interested in undergraduate research but not sure how to get their feet wet?
Yeah, I mean, that's the most important thing is just to reach out, you know, have some motivation, have some self-motivation, and reach out through the network of faculty and other students. So usually what we encourage students to do is to have a little bit of homework where they look at the websites of the different professors, because we do vastly different things. We have four like major distinctions in terms of the type of work that's done, the type of studies, but you know, they're vastly different. So as to look at the different areas, you know, see maybe 2, 3, 4, 5 that you might be interested in, send them an email or stop by their office and say hello, introduce yourself. Or often you're in classes with these same faculty. So again, go up to them, introduce yourself, say, I'm interested. And usually that starts a conversation, and it's just a matter of sort of timing as to when you can do something with that professor's research or that professor's lab. So usually these things are set up a semester in advance, sometimes a little bit longer in advance, sometimes much shorter lead time. The conversation starts at all.
And how many semesters would you recommend that undergraduate students have? Is there a set number?
There's definitely not a set number. So, you know, anything greater than zero, you know, and the length of time doesn't always correlate with the, you know, the extent or the quality of the experience. So even one semester worth can be, you know, really all a student needs, all a person needs. The more experiences you can get, or the deeper experiences in the same lab, the better off, just because you have more variety. Some students start in a lab and stay there multiple semesters. Other students start in one place and then go to a different area and then a different area. You know, it's really all up to the kind of individual guidance between the students and the professors. We're never doing the same thing every day, never.
Mm-hmm. That's part of what makes it so exciting, I think.
For me, at least, yeah, too. And I think for the students as well.
Yes, and for us, it's always nice to just, like I said, have that hands-on experience and really get in there and learn what, or apply what you've learned in your classes.
And they learn a lot, not just from the professor themselves, but from other people in the lab. So there's postdoctoral fellows in the lab, there's PhD and master's students in the labs, and there's other undergraduates in the labs. So anyone with more experience has a wealth of knowledge to share.
Yes, and would you recommend that all students get involved, or all BSPS students get involved in research, or just those particularly interested in pursuing a career in research?
Well, that's a really hard question to answer. Certainly, it's not going to hurt anyone. You know, if you want to find out if this is the type of work that you enjoy, then certainly getting into, and you can do it like bench work in the labs. There's also quite a few areas that do different kinds of computer work, computational work, of all different kinds. And so really just getting the experience and exploring. The advantage of doing some kind of research project is that it's fairly wide open, but it's very much figure it out as you go along. And so that's different than, you know, any classroom situation. That's different than many of the different teaching labs. But it really gives you a good idea as to what kind of environment you might want to work in. And that's, you know, the more you can learn about different possibilities, the better.
Absolutely.